Now we say hello to Joe Smith, who covers the Bolts for The Athletic. And Joe, I want to start with Louis Domingue, who's between the pipes for the 11th straight game. He is holding down the fort, but has been a little leaky of late. Are you sensing some fatigue for the netminder?
Not necessarily. Maybe a little bit physically. Mentally, he told me the other day he feels fine. But it's natural. He starts 11 straight games the first time in a couple years for him. He has been not as sharp the last three or four games, but he's found a way to win with some game-saving stops on Thursday against Buffalo to enable them to win that game. And Saturday in overtime against the Panthers, they had a big save there to help them with that win that game. So it has always been pretty. But considering he's 7-2 since taking over Vasilevsky after a fracture of his foot, so the Lightning will certainly take that one.
No, definitely. After Vasi went down, there was some concern, but Domingue has eased some of that. As you mentioned, he's won 7 of his last 10 starts, and he's got the Devils again tonight. Nikita Kucherov, we know what to expect from him. When you talk to him about his recent play, what does he have to say?
Well, you know, Nikita Kucherov never really completely satisfied with his games. He had 100 points last year, wasn't always happy with that, but he's clearly been in his zone the last week or so. He had 4 three-point games in the last 9. Saturday might have been his best game of the year. Enabled that comeback from 3 goals down in the second period, a big setup on Joseph's goal. He scored another one to make it 4-3, and he's at his best when he's engaged in the game, and he's playing with really good chemistry with Tyler Johnson and Braden Point. So overall, you're seeing some of the best of Nikita Kucherov so far this season, the past week or so, I think.
Kucherov, you see his season stats with the team and how he ranks second in goals, tops in assists, power play points. Yeah, Kuch is still good. Eric Chernak has done a nice job filling in on the blue line. What's helped him settle in there, filling in for Anton Strålman?
Well, he's a fundamentally sound defenseman. He's a big guy, 6'4", 225 pounds. He uses it well. He can skate well for a big guy and really forms good chemistry with Ryan McDonough in that shutdown pair that you would usually have Strålman and McDonough. He's a big guy, and he's actually used to being played in big moments against bigger guys. When he was 16 years old, he played in the Slovakian men's league against guys who were 35 years old or 40, so he knows what he needs to handle his bigger situation. So overall, he couldn't be any more pleased with the guy they got from in the Ben Bishop trade to LA Kings 2.5 years ago.
I imagine you could learn a thing or two playing at 16 years old in the Slovakian men's league for Eric Chernak. I want to finish up with Braden Point. We saved the best for last, Joe. If Kucherov is heating up, I don't know how you describe the way that Braden Point has been playing all season long. What have been the key steps in his progression in your eyes?
Well, I think obviously there's a lot of times this year where he's been their best player on this team. I think overall he's just a relentless work ethic. If you don't really see any slumps from him offensively or defensively, he's got a little bit better at faceoffs, which he wanted to improve on from last year. And not just offensively, where he has 19 goals and leads the team in game-winning goals, but to the other end of the ice. You'll see tonight, when Taylor Hall's on the ice tonight, you'll see a lot of Braden Point. He's a big shutdown center, takes all those tougher matchups in the league, and he's really developing a reputation as one of the better two-way centers, I think, in the NHL.
Joe Smith, if you follow the Bolts, you know who he is. If you want to read more of his work, you could do so at The Athletic. Joe, enjoy the game tonight.